I don't think there's any film this year that I've had my eye on with equally as much anticipation and skepticism as Avatar: The Way of Water. The first film basically pioneered the next decade of cinema, now the second film has finally been released after a 13-year wait. It's certainly one of the year's biggest films in terms of cost, plot, spectacle, and runtime, but is it actually worth watching? I'll be light on the plot details given the anticipation over this, but let's just get this out of the way. The first movie's strengths came more from the revolutionary spectacle than the plot, and the same is definitely true here. It's a decent enough storyline, but nothing amazing. That's not to say they didn't try. There is world-building being done here, and there's slightly more depth to the story. It does feel like a true sequel. But let's be honest, you're not going to watch this movie for a masterwork of screenwriting. The buzz around Avatar was always the visual effects, and after 13 years of CGI making everything and anything possible, this movie has to deliver. And deliver it does. Avatar: The Way of Water is, in no uncertain terms, gorgeous. It is breathtaking. It's the best looking movie I've seen in a long time. And you can tell that's part of the film's aim because so much of the movie's 3-hour plus runtime is dedicated to non-stop eye candy. In fact, I didn't even feel the film's length that much because I was so immersed in the world. I can tell you that Pandora still stuns after all these years. That said, technical achievement will only get you so far. I'm recording this in December 2022, and who knows where cinema will be several years down the line. Aside from maybe Avatar 5, at least. This film may be cutting edge now, but it may end up showing its age. Thankfully, the rest of the spectacle delivers as well. The action is great, especially the third act. It has the kind of set pieces that make for a great theatrical experience. Speaking of which, there's something I should probably mention. Now, I understand not everybody will be willing or able to shell out for the premium Way of Water experience in 3D, but I'm betting those who can will. I can't say for certain, but my guess is that many of the higher-end 3D screenings, such as IMAX and Dolby Cinema, will be projected at 48 frames per second like mine was. At best, a higher frame rate really heightens the more intense action sequences and gives the visual effects a sense of added realism. The underwater scenes look great like this, as if you're watching a sci-fi version of one of Cameron's documentaries. However, this realism is also a flaw. It diminishes the cinematic nature of the piece by making it look too real and too smooth. More soap opera than space opera, as it were, or an insanely high-end video game. Also, most of the film is projected like this, but not all of it. Some scenes are still at 24 frames per second, and it does make it look a bit awkward, especially since there's often no clear rhyme or reason to the frame rate changes, often switching back and forth in the same scene. Since this is generally a more controversial gimmick, I just wanted to let you know in advance. Is Avatar: The Way of Water the must-see film of the year? In my opinion, I'd say not really. At least not in general. However, it's one of the best theatrical experiences I've had this year, or even in a while. And if you can see this on the big screen, you absolutely should. Just make sure it's the biggest, best screen you can possibly find. And yes, in 3D also. Now all Cameron has to do is deliver on Avatar 3. And if this does well, 4 and 5.